enjoying some food. Hi, everyone who's watching the live stream. We're getting a little bit of a late start. So just bear with us and hang on. We're going to open with some wonderful young string students' performances to start off the Musicale. These are students of David Yonan and Charlie Pickler, and also piano students of my own, and coaching. I coach them as well. So Steve and I will accompany them. There's three students, all siblings, and they are Aidan and Keelan and Aislin Watts. So we'll be hearing some very lovely music from them shortly. Handel and Beethoven and Paganini. So sit tight because some music's coming and some of our guests are enjoying some food. We wish you could be here, but you'll get to enjoy the music. I'd like to introduce Aislin Watts. Aislin, how old are you?
13.
Aislin is 13 years old. She is a student of David Yonan's and Charlie Pickler, and who else? Lavinia Lee. And she is also my piano student, and I also coach her on violin. So we are going to play for you. Why don't you announce what we're going to play?
Beethoven Romance.
Quiet on the set, please.
Okay.
instrument. Violin is her primary instrument. Next we have Aislin's older sister, Keelian. Keelian, come on in. You can look at the cameras and
okay.
Tell us what grade you are in school now, what year?
I'm a junior in high school.
And what will we be playing together today?
I'm playing the Henry Cassidy's Viola Concerto in B minor in the style of Handel.
Very nice. Okay. So, and your viola teacher is who?
Charlie Pickler.
Very good. Excellent. So, here we go. Orchestrated by Cassidy. Yes, just for our recording and listening audience. If someone can inform my husband to quiet the dog, we have to do something. Okay. Ready? children, Aidan Watts. Come on in, Aidan. Aidan is a senior, and tell us what you're going to play. I'm not accompanying Aidan today, Steve is. And he's actually playing a piece very near and dear to my heart because I play the Liszt Paganini version. So tell us about your piece, and please enjoy this wonderful young talent. We love working with Aidan and with Keelan and with Aislin. The whole family so talented.
Same to
you. Okay, thank you.
I am playing the Paganini Caprice number 24.
It's a very famous theme.
Thank you.
student of mine, relatively new. I guess you've been studying with me this fall since.
Yes.
And this is Elaine Ubando. And Elaine was trained at the Cincinnati College Conservatory of Music, where she received a BM in violin performance. But she came to me to study piano. And I discovered she's quite a wonderful pianist and had excellent training. She just didn't have a lot of repertoire under her belt. So we're really diving into a lot of repertoire. And today you're going, come on in. This is where the video, you're being videoed. So welcome, Elaine. This is Elaine's first time coming to our annual New Year's Day Musicale. And what will you play for us today?
I'm going to play maybe two or three of Skuryabin's preludes.
Great.
That was 11 preludes.
Great. Elaine is a violin teacher and also a piano teacher, so that makes me a piano teacher to piano teachers. she's actually one of two piano teachers that I teach and coach at the present time. So, I think you really enjoy her playing, so you get your choice of pianos. Mostly you're used to that one.
Yes, that's true.
So you might want that one.
Well,
you can play that one.
Let's go with this one. That one I know.
Okay, so now you get to hear a different instrument. And a little later today, you'll hear two pianos, and you'll also be hearing from my piano trio with violinist Cyrus Forough and Nazar Dzhuryn, the cellist. And we will be having some really fun impromptu chamber music readings. So the fun thing about this is it's New Year's Day Musicale is really a hybrid event. It's a social event primarily, but with music, and some of it's rehearsed and prepared, and some of it is just really ad hoc, impromptu. Whomever shows up and has instruments and music, we invite to come together, and we literally don't know who's going to come and when, so we're putting things together often on the spot. But right now, please enjoy Elaine Ubando at the piano, and I think we'll be hearing a little from you on the violin as well today, so I'm really excited because I haven't even heard you play violin. So I know you love her piano playing, so have at it. You can announce if you like.
What
pieces you're playing. Thank you. the challenge of playing an event such as this is that there's really no time to warm up, and people are eating and drinking and having a good time, and then just have to sit down or stand up and play their instruments. So it's really designed to be an informal thing, but I think from what we just heard, some absolutely beautiful music, portends a very wonderful musicale for today. So my next guest, our next featured musician, who we will be hearing from now and a little bit later in the musicale, is a relatively new friend of mine. We've just met today, but we knew each other on Facebook, and we were introduced by a mutual friend, David Yonin, who is now in Berlin, Germany. And we discovered that we have quite a few things in common. One, we both studied at the Manhattan School of Music and with the same teacher, Constance Keen. So that's really kind of really neat. And I had heard about Victor Goldberg. I had heard about him, seen him on Facebook, but today is the very first day that we've met, and I'm just very pleased to welcome you here to Chicago. Come on in. And you can talk a little bit. Great to see you, Victor. Just a little background about Victor, because sometimes people don't like to talk about themselves. Victor is Ukrainian and Israeli. Israeli by way of Ukraine, or Ukrainian by way of Israel, now American. So born in Ukraine and raised in Israel, and now living here in the United States. So I will give the floor over to Victor, and this is the first time that I'm hearing him play, so I'm really excited, and he will announce his pieces that he's going to play right now. So please give him a warm welcome.
Thank you. I'll play a couple of short pieces. So the first one is Sonata by Scarlatti in E major. When we hear word sonata, we usually think about a piece of several movements, three or four movements. In this case, basically, Scarlatti thought about it as exercise, so it's like a study. He was an Italian composer who lived much of his life in Spain and served the queen. And you can hear in this music a lot of Mediterranean flavor. A lot of, it's not a very profound music, but it's very nice music, and it's very expressive. And that's why in the second half, I would say, of the 20th century, started kind of a rebirth of Scarlatti. He was pianists love playing his pieces, and the audience loves listening to it. So I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
second piece I'm going to play is just a short piece, also a short piece by a romantic composer, a Russian romantic, Pyotr Ilyich Tchaikovsky. I'm sure you all heard about him. So Tchaikovsky was a great composer. He composed symphonies, he composed concerti, and this particular cycle, which is called the seasons, there are 12 seasons, 12 months of the year. And Tchaikovsky was assigned, was commissioned to write music for some journal in St. Petersburg, which was published every month, and every month he was supposed to bring to send them a piece of music corresponding to that month. And he didn't pay much attention to that assignment, and he told his kammerdiener, he told his aide to remind him a couple of days before it was due so that he has to compose it. And at the same time, the journal was for amateur musicians, so just for music lovers, not necessarily for professional pianists. So most of those pieces are technically not extremely difficult, other than the one that I'm going to play right now, which is August, Harvest. So I'm guessing that Harvest is means a lot of work, physical work, so I guess Tchaikovsky was also meant for pianists to work hard in order to produce this image of Harvest. So here it is.
Thank you.
more musicians that have just arrived and more yet to come. I think right now we'll just take a little break so that we can socialize and get replenished with food and drink as needed. And we will return with Tchaikovsky, more Tchaikovsky, with on two pianos, an annual favorite, the Nutcracker Suite on two pianos by me and Steve Green, my husband. But because I don't know where he is right now, we will adjourn for a short little break. Okay. Oh, there you are. Well, when do you want to do Tchaikovsky? You want to take a break now? We're taking a break. Or not. You want to do Tchaikovsky? Okay, well, a lot of people have food, so if you want to play and keep it going. Okay, let's take a show of hands. Who wants music to continue right now? Okay. They want music, I think. Okay, change your plans. We will continue with Tchaikovsky. Everybody have food? Everybody has what they want?
There's more than enough.
There's plenty. I wish our viewers online could have enjoyed the food as well. Would that be something if we could do a virtual food party and everyone could taste what I've made?
No. Susan, can we do a salute to you?
Oh,
you
thank
did
you.
Everything.
Yeah. Well,
that's great.
Okay, this week was noodle kugels and chicken salads and sweet and sour meatballs and cakes and things. Thank you. Okay, right now we're going to continue with a little Tchaikovsky. And, oh, I see some more arriving musicians. Oh, wow, we've got a piano, we've got everything. We've got another pianist, so I think we'll go with this and then we'll take a little break and we'll figure out what the next group will be. Introduction. I just had the good fortune of attending the Joffrey Ballet's production of The Nutcracker, which is very new. It's very sort of modern interpretation because it's set not in a grand home in Russia, but in 1895 Chicago. The setting is the World's Fair exposition. But the names of the characters are changed, but the essential qualities were not. It was one of the most incredibly beautiful productions that I've seen of The Nutcracker ever. It's now closed, it's run for this year, but be sure to see it next year if you haven't. Believe it or not, I've lived here in Chicago for now 20 years and only saw the Joffrey Ballet's Nutcracker performance for the first time just this past week. So. Anyway, here's our rendition of some of the highlights from Tchaikovsky's ballet, The Nutcracker.
Thank you.
We're taking a break, but next up will be my Sheridan Solisti piano trio performing some Schubert and Brahms. So I need a break. You guys need a break.
Everybody,
we're taking a little short intermission and enjoy some drink and food and talk.
Susan, this is my delightful assistant, Sarah.
Everyone, please take your seats if you would like to listen to some more music. There's no microphone. We are going to resume for our online live stream audience. I have with me two dear friends, Irina Feoktistova. Irina is a dear friend of mine. We are a piano duo together and also a member of our four piano ensemble, Pianissimo. And she is here with one of her dear friends, Tanya, Dybal, soprano. And they will announce their selections. They have been presented by my studio when I had the downtown studio in the Fine Arts Building. And I assure you, you're in for a wonderful treat. They always have very entertaining vocal and piano selections. So take it away.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. I'm very happy to be here and sing for you. And I will start with Puccini. I believe 2024 is the year of Puccini, but I'm not sure what exactly, but I think there is some anniversary with Puccini. And I will start from Che bel sogno di Doretta. Is Aria Magda from La Rondina.
By Deliver, and it's called Le Quai de Cadix, and it's
about young girl. She's hanging around with her friends. She she's not rich, let's say, and she likes to dance, enjoy her life. And in second verse, a gentleman came to her and he said to her, "Do you want jewelries or that I have, the gold that I have, just be mine?" And she said, no, I don't need you, pass away. Yeah, she just wants to do what she wants.
Thank you.
38. It's unfortunate he lived much longer than he after this when he wrote, but for some reason he didn't like what his music. It's just unfortunate for us, for singers and musicians, that so beautiful music can be much more written, but here it is. And the text is from, who wrote the text? Celebrate. Okay, I will say a little bit, okay. But basically, what is the
somebody
most beautiful?
Playing, sorry, somebody playing music over there?
Yeah, they just,
it's not here, that way.
Oh, somebody's warming up.
We'll just see. Don't worry. We'll just see. It's so okay.
We have a powerful voice and we won't hear it.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. it's Brahms, it's not Schumann.
Thank you.
Thank you.
those of you would like to hear some more piano music, are you ready to play now? You would like to? Okay. We will continue with music by Victor Goldberg. Some of you have come a little bit late and you missed his earlier performance, so you now get to be treated to another performance by Victor. And it will be some different selections. And
good job.
All right, honey.
Hello again.
Hello.
So I am going to play two short pieces. One by Tchaikovsky.
It's very hard. We know that there's so much enthusiasm and also
we're just having a really good time.
No,
we're having a great time. So it is a party and it's a musicale and it's not a formal concert, so we understand.
It's a great competition between food and music, and they, you know,
it's a great
who knows what is more important.
Yes. So go ahead, introduce your pieces, enjoy the piano.
Exactly.
I had to finish my part because I know your big piece you're going to play is a big piece, and I wanted my piano not to go out of tune. And it's already going out of tune. So
I played enough big pieces. Yeah.
Okay. Anyway. Enjoy it.
No, my big piece is like 3 minutes of music. That's a big piece she's referring to. But actually, those are two short pieces. One is very slow, and the other is very fast. So the slow one is Tchaikovsky, October, Autumn Song from the Seasons. And the fast one is Rachmaninoff Musical Moments. So Tchaikovsky, that particular piece, is originally was written for published in an amateur journal, amateur magazine for amateur pianists. So it's not technically difficult at all, but yet it's a required piece of Tchaikovsky competition in Moscow. So why is it a required piece? Because you need to produce a lot of music through few notes, basically. So so that's a very nice piece by Tchaikovsky. And the second one is Rachmaninoff. Musical moment, well, that's what it is, a moment of music. What is interesting about it is that there is a figuration in the left hand that and the melody is in the right hand. So the figuration is actually, in a way, more important than the melody. That figuration is the one that grows and grows and grows and eventually becomes very big and then it ends.
Thank you. Let me see.
used to playing second.
Do you want to switch?
Switch.
I don't have my glasses. I brought my glasses case with no glasses.
Wait, how come you don't want to? How come you
don't? Isn't this bar?
I'm joking around. Nora and I know each other really well.
Is the bar versus time goes on?
Is it what?
We learn new mistakes to make that we've never made before.
What?
Wow.
What?
Good thing you have a good sense of humor.
Should we try it while we wait for our
No!
Choice?
We're just going to throw it to the wind.
You can
throw
my glasses.
You
can tell who's going to be the
I need some dinner.
Thank you. Thank you.
spot again. No, at C, what do you have as a pickup? An A?
At C?
No, that's a G.
G.
G, as in gargantuous?
Yes.
Okay.
Gargantuan.
Okay. I'm going to count us in. I'm going to count us in at G. One, two, one, two.
Я не думаю, что надо.